Now available on Tata Sky channel number 526.
Now, home buyers in a Gurgaon project are refusing to accept possession of their homes from the developer. The reason? They allege the developer has not followed safety norms. My colleague Suvesha Sawant sent us this report. Take a look.
These are some of the 2,000 plus home buyers in BPTP's Park Serene project in Gurgaon. After waiting nearly 4 years for their homes, BPTP had promised possession in 2012. These buyers have now refused to move in. The reason? BPTP is handing over the OC or occupancy certificate for 4 out of 7 towers only. And these two, buyers allege, are unsafe.
We are contending that all 7 towers should be given the OC together with all habitable facilities. The major concern being security, with the high tension wire which is going right across the society, as well as the ongoing constructions across the towers, is a security hazard.
Even if we have to take a possession, they give us an offer of possession, we don't feel safe to think about living here when there are security concerns. There is a basic amenity like water issue. There is no sewage. Even the electricity that they are offering is just a 125 kVA for 400 plus families. There is a high tension cable that passes through the project. So these are some of the key issues that we are facing right now.
Home buyers in BPTP's Park Serene fear if they accept the OC, the developer may not deliver promised amenities. The occupancy certificate, commonly called OC, is an official document that the developer has to obtain from local authorities before handing over possession. For buyers, it is the equivalent of an all-clear signal. We also contacted BPTP, but the management refused to comment on camera. However, they sent us the following response on email.
All requisite safety norms have been adhered to. The same has been ratified by the authorities as well. That said, there were certain minor observations made which were limited to barricading of certain portions of the group housing, minor finishing related works, etc. We have followed all safety norms in the larger interest of our customers. We have already initiated the requisite works and the same will be completed in the next 30 days.
This is not the first instance where home buyers in BPTP's Park Serene have taken on the developer. Earlier in 2011, buyers alleged BPTP had escalated costs by 35%. Buyers had gone to court then and demanded rollback of the escalation and penalty for delayed possession. This case is currently under arbitration. This is Suvesha Sawant for Magic Bricks Now.
All right, to get a legal perspective on this, joining me live is Aditya Vadva from Delhi. Aditya, welcome to the show. First of all, tell us, what are the legal implications if the buyer takes possession without getting an OC?
One is running the risk of a subsequent demolition order. That's the first legal consequence which can happen if one was to take possession without the OC. The second legal consequence is under specifically Haryana, now that we are talking about Gurgaon, under the Haryana Development Authority Act, Section 55 provides for a conviction. So it says Section 54 lays down, gives the power to the subordinate legislation to frame rules, and Section 55 says that if one is to flout any rule, that could also lead to a conviction. Now the conviction can be, the sentence to the conviction can be twofold. One is, if it is a one-time conviction, it could be 500 rupees. If it is a recurrent conviction, in our case it would be a recurrent offence, it would be 50 rupees per day. But even if the monetary aspect of the sentencing is not a disincentive enough for a buyer to not occupy a premises without the occupation certificate, one must understand that there are a lot of legal consequences attached to a conviction, because this is a legal conviction.
Now, let also tell us, if the buyers refuse to accept OC, like in the case of BPTP that we just saw, what are the risks they would be running into? Also, how can they safeguard their rights?
If the buyer refuses to accept the OC, there is, in a purely pedantic legal manner, there is no risk that the buyer is running, because there is a valid and a legitimate reason for the buyer to not accept the OC. As I am given to understand, the buyer is refusing in our case to accept the OC because the buyer feels that there are certain norms like the fire norms and other norms mentioned in the NCB that the builder has not followed. If that is so, what I would advise the buyer to do is to write a legal notice or send out a legal notice to the HUDA and to the builder, telling them that look, these norms have not been satisfied or been followed in this particular building, despite which an OC has been given. What we would like you to do is to re-examine the OC and tell us whether or not the OC was validly given or not. In the event that the HUDA does not respond, the buyer can file a writ petition in the High Court, in the concerned High Court, which is in Chandigarh, directing the HUDA to while keeping in mind all the norms, give a conclusive certificate whether or not the building has in fact followed all the norms. So these are two things that the buyer can do. And thirdly, if the builder refuses to act, it can, of course, the buyer can take the builder to the NCDRC, which is the third option which is available.
Alright, also tell us, if the builder is offering occupation certificate and the buyer refuses to accept it, can the builder turn around from his responsibility?
It prima facie indicates, or in most cases it necessarily indicates, that all the norms have been complied with. But there have been cases, and courts have been recognizing situations where the OC has been wrongfully given. And it is that eventuality that we need to concern ourselves in this case. Even if the OC is given, if you feel that there are certain regulations that have not been complied with, you need to take corrective measures. Because despite the owner having obtained the OC, and despite you having moved into a premises upon pursuant to the owner giving you OC, if tomorrow the regulator realizes that certain norms have not been complied with and have been flouted, the consequences will still ensue.
Alright, Aditya, thank you so much for joining us here on Magic Bricks Now.
You can watch live TV on our website mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at Magic Bricks Now. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.